afternoon. I'm going to talk briefly about two related pilot projects, one with Elsevier and the other with Chorus, that demonstrate one way academic libraries and publishers are working together for interoperability between information systems. Before beginning these projects, I had discussions over several years with my provost, my vice president for research, members of the faculty, including our Faculty Research Council, about the need to document and provide improved access to faculty research without placing additional burdens on already busy faculty. With the development of the White House OSTP policy that Ginger's just described, the mandates for deposit of the results of federally funded research changed these discussions to begin to include the word compliance. All of these discussions eventually still ended with that plea, why can't the library solve this problem without placing an additional burden on our already very busy faculty? UF authors publish approximately 8,000 scholarly journal articles a year. Unfortunately, our faculty do not have a culture of deposit of their article manuscripts in the institutional repository, although many do rely on it for deposit of other content. In fact, when we started the Elsevier project, we had 7 Elsevier journal articles in our IR, and they were all fully funded open access articles. Obviously, it would be very expensive and time-consuming for library staff to track down all those manuscripts, and responding to the demands of those manuscripts would definitely place additional burdens, not just on the faculty, but on the library staff. When I first saw this slide, the word compliance was, as it is now, in the center, but there was one less figure on the slide. I went up to Howard Ratner after his presentation about Chorus and told him that the person on my campus who was losing sleep over compliance wasn't on his slide, the vice president of research. I acknowledged the need to focus the initial development of Chorus on publishers and funding agencies, but pointed out that this was a three-legged stool, and there were three figures from the academic institutions, once we added the VP research, the librarian, the VP, and the researcher, who were not participating in the design of the Chorus system. I suggested that when they were ready, UF and other academic institutions should participate in the development of Chorus to ensure that it met our needs as well as those of the publishers and funders. A few months ago, Howard contacted me and said they were ready to expand the partnership and asked if UF would participate, and I quickly agreed. This offer came about in part because of the pilot project we had already begun with Elsevier, which Chorus members had been observing closely. And I note here that the researcher is both a potential author and a reader, so filling two roles that we're talking about today. The most frequent question I get asked about these projects is this one, why Elsevier and why Chorus? And I think this slide answers that question. As I mentioned, UF authors publish approximately 8,000 articles a year, and 8 of the 10 publishers most selected by UF authors are Chorus members. Elsevier has the largest volume of any single publisher, with somewhere between 1,100 and 1,300 articles per year, followed by Springer Nature and Wiley. Automated solutions for identification and access to articles by UF authors from multiple publishers reduces the burden on our academic faculty, the library faculty and staff, and by sharing the data on compliance on the staff of the Office of Compliance under the VP Research. Another reason that I'm often asked about is, so why would Elsevier and Chorus be willing to come to UF? And I think the first answer is because I asked. It helps to have a willing partner. But the second is because UF is a large, comprehensive, research-intensive university. We rank 6th in the U.S. in production of PhDs, with 796 awarded last year. And as you can see from this slide, a huge range of subject matter, and therefore a huge range of both agencies who fund us and journals in which we publish. This is a brief slide for the opening of the Chorus Institutional Dashboard. Chorus had been designing dashboards for the funding agencies that would allow them to track articles that resulted from their funding, and what they're doing with us now and with the University of Denver, who's another early participant in the pilot, is developing an institutional dashboard specifically designed for the universities. And what this will let us do is it will let us determine articles have been published by our authors. It will validate whether they already appear in the appropriate institutional repository, or as Ginger noted, sometimes more than one, because it may be jointly funded by several agencies. And then we can share that information with the Office of Compliance. So if they know that a specific author has published an article, they can match it back to the grant and their grant management system, and they can see that the compliance has already occurred or that it has not yet occurred, and that allows them to track it over time and, as a result, then really only have to chase down the articles where compliance has not already occurred. So that significantly reduces their burden. So I'll end with that and just say that the sort of mantra that we've been following is that compliance is very real and we will ignore it at our peril. So I know that our university, and I'm sure many others, view the cost of compliance as a major new responsibility of the university, and we're doing what we can in cooperation with Elsevier and with Chorus to make that happen. So thank you very much.